An 18 forecast, News 18, weather from where you live.
We talked about this last night, how we would have this interesting little merger of two systems that will produce snow in the Midwest and across the East. Now, it looked like the merger would be here last night, but it's more west tonight. Notice this system here and then all the deep moisture down here. We're having this little merger take place, and notice as that occurs, the snow is blossoming really from Iowa, Missouri, all the way down into southern Illinois, and really it's been pretty amazing to watch the snow really blow up here with that happening. Notice not much going on just a couple hours ago, and then boom, all the snow develops and the snow rapidly expanding here in Iowa. So bottom line is the snow is headed our way, though the heaviest is going to be down here in the southern part of the state where there's a winter storm warning in effect. But there's Lafayette. This is Crawford Zone. If you look to the southwest, there's some of that snow rapidly expanding and filling in, and that's going to start to move in as we head in to tonight and slowly taper tomorrow. So tonight we'll drop into the upper 20s, the average low 17, so at least chemicals will work well on roads with 28 degrees. We've got that snow tonight and largely Saturday morning. Now I'm hesitant because I think there will be some flurries and a few snow showers that may hang on into the afternoon, though most of the snow will be tonight and Saturday morning. Briefly drier and cooler, and then New Year's Eve into New Year's Day, accumulating snow as well. Now, after upper 20s tonight, we'll be around freezing tomorrow, 32 Burlington, Lafayette, Attica, as well as Crawfordsville. The winds crank up tomorrow, but at least it's a wet snow, so even though there may be a little bit of blowing and drifting with these gusts of 25 as we head towards 4 p.m., I don't think it'll be nearly as bad as it was yesterday. Notice on Futurecast here, or a couple of days ago anyway, here comes the blue. That's the snow coming up from the south and the southwest as we head into the evening. It kind of expands across the viewing area as we head into the overnight and even into Saturday morning. But notice as we go through time Saturday, most of the snow pulls away. But again, there will be a few flurries and at least some spotty snow showers that kind of pivot in from the northwest, largely due to perhaps a little lake influence here. And then skies slowly start to clear out tomorrow night, and we'll have mostly sunny skies on Sunday. This was the map yesterday with most of the heavy snow kind of east of us and northwest of us. This is the new data today, kind of shifting it to the southwest because the merger will take place here rather than here. For us, generally around an inch to around 2 inches, around 2 Frankfort, Thorntown, 2.3 Atlanta, near an inch Monticello up towards Winnemac, Lafayette, and also towards Covington. And then we got to watch that storm in California headed our way as we move into next week. In fact, my New Year's Eve, New Year's Day, snow will expand across the area, generally about an inch and a half in the north to as much as 6 inches in our southern counties. 7-day forecast, the cold and kind of snowy pattern rolls on here, but mostly sunny Sunday, some snow later in Monday into early Tuesday, and then perhaps even a little bit more snow by Friday. This pattern will start to break a little bit once we get closer to about the 9th. Some rain by that point, highs in the 40s for a couple of days.
All right, your folks in southern Indiana really getting a winter, aren't
they? Yeah, mom and dad got a foot, and they're going to get about 7 inches tonight.
Well,
my goodness.
Yeah.
All right, Chad, thank you. Mm-hmm. Okay, Caleb's in with sports now. We're